Welcome back, dear viewers. You're still watching Nile Cruz live on Nile TV. And we have with us today, honored by President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi for editing Braal magazine, a very special guest, which is Mr. Ahmed Abu Hameela, a journalist and member of the Youth Committee in the Cultural Higher Committee. Some 15% of the entire global population lives with a type of disability. 4% of those experience grave difficulties in mobility, functioning, and going about their day-to-day activities. Sadly, the percentage of people who have some form of disability has increased due to aging populations and the spread of endemics and or specific diseases in some countries, according to the World Health Organization. And in this context, dear viewers, we have with us, as I just mentioned, Mr. Ahmed Abu Hameela to tell us more about all the difficulties that face disabilities and the advantages of as well that President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi gave this year in the year 2018.
Mr. Ahmed, thank you very much for being with us today on Nile Cruz.
Thank you. It's my pleasure to be with you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you once again. Mr. Ahmed, if we can speak about the efforts of President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, the Parliament, and of course the 2014 Constitution regarding the rights of the persons with disabilities. How do you see them?
Really, in Egypt nowadays, we see a new phase in the importance of the role for people with disabilities in the society. First of all, the declaration of this year to be a year for people with disabilities really highlighted the efforts and all potentials in Egypt and in the society about those sector which we can say was marginalized for a lot of years. Now we see a shift, a change in the perception from the society to the disabled people. From more than perspective, first of all, now the people began to treat them with respect, with appreciation, not only with sympathy. All the society began to acknowledge their role and their abilities. Really, in Egypt this year, we saw a lot of models from all different of disabilities, visually or with wheelchair or with hearing problems. We saw a lot of models that inspired us, which overcame all difficulties and began to achieve a lot of goals and a lot of work that ordinary people may don't achieve it. Also in the sport, in Paralympic Games, we see them win a lot of prizes and honored. Really, as I said, it's a change in the perception for people with disabilities, not only to treat them with sympathy, but give them the opportunity, provide them with their tools, what they need of tools, and they will do a lot of work that will inspire all of us.
Mr. Ahmed, there is a two-way link between poverty and disability. One that is, of course, due to a vicious circle, a circle, which is poverty feeding disability and disability feeding poverty. How can this cycle be broken?
Really, it's really matters because poverty affects disabilities. When families have children, even if these children were not with disability, the poverty, and if they don't have enough money and enough education, poverty also affects the level of education. If they haven't the enough level and we can say level of high level of life to treat their children and with the qualifications and to give them the medical care that they need. Really, we the disability will double in the society. So the health ministry in Egypt began to raise aware about that to discover the disability before it's happened. If we didn't can explore it, we will see a lot of problems. On the other hand, we can avoid a lot of problems in society if we can raise the awareness among the families. So I can say it's a shared responsibility, not only for the family, not only for the government, but also for the civil society organization. If we see it from a comprehensive vision, we can say that it's a shared responsibility between all of us, because it's not the problem of the family itself or the person with disability. All of us should work together to give a hand of help to them to overcome their disabilities.
Yes, Mr. Ahmed, you've mentioned two keywords for the persons with disabilities here in Egypt: appreciation and, of course, being respected here in the country. How can those two words be changing the lives of millions or thousands of people here in Egypt?
As you said, it's about the perception of the society for people with disabilities. If we can respect them, we treat them as a human being, a human being, not only as a person from second level of citizenship, or he have a lack in his personality, not in his tools. To have a problem in body, it's not doesn't mean that the person have problem in his mind or in his personality.
Yes.
We really not need a lot of work to further integration for them in the society, to make this vision spread all over sectors, in villages, in cities, in schools, in colleges or universities. The people with disability need only the chance, the opportunity to provide them with their tools, and they will do their best to provide them with accessibility. We suffer a lot of problems because there is no accessibility in some places. Not only accessibility in infrastructure like buildings or public transportation, but also accessibility for the people with disability to get to the knowledge and the culture, and to be an effective element in the community. So when we treat the people with disabilities with equality, with as a human being, he only need some tools, some help to achieve what he aiming to. When we provide them with these tools, they will inspire us, as I said, not only to sympathize and to give them aids or to help them with money or also, but to provide them with their tools in work, in movement, in the community. The society is measured with how it treat the disabled people. When we see the people of a country treat people with disability with respect and appreciate their rules in the society, we can see this community is on a level of civilization or that. Here in Egypt in this year, really we witnesses, as I said, a change in the perception. Began this vision or this perception began to change. I hope this to be the beginning in for the first years, for the next years. Now we have a law in Egypt. This law guarantee a lot of rights for people with disabilities in housing, in health, in education,
Job opportunities and
job
as well.
Opportunities, yeah.
And I think and schools now, it's possible for people who are disabled to go to every type of school. They're allowed everywhere now.
Yeah, it's the first year, to be allowed. Last years or before, they were prevented from to enter some colleges or some schools, but now all universities are accessible to them, all colleges. This really shift for them to give their rights in the education and in the culture, as I said. I hope to be a beginning in all fields also, not only in education, because we can, if we enabled them, we can gain a lot of, I can say, a lot of efforts, a lot of energy to participate in building their society and the country.
Mr. Ahmed, do you see it as an advantage or a disadvantage that they are enabled now to enter all type of schools and universities? Is this going to be an advantage or a disadvantage? Because as we all know, they need special treatment and they need to be handled in a different way. So yes, they are able now to enter every different school and every different university, but is this good for their sake?
Yeah, thank you for this question. Really, it relates which kind of education. It needs a lot of awareness from the family, from the parents to choose the suitable place for their children or the person. Because as you said, if we allow them to enter all kind of education, it's maybe this advantage if he entered a field or career doesn't suit to him, he will fail. The real success is to put them in the right place. It also depends on the awareness of the family, as I said, and the society to provide them and to give them the opportunity to the right place, not only to allow them in education or any university to gain the best of their energy in them. If he is talented in sport, he can join faculty of sports, if he in any kind of arts or education. So as you said, it depends on the awareness from the family and the people with disabilities themselves. To get the best of them.
After dedicating 2018 for the persons with special needs, what are your aspirations for 2019 as a journalist as well?
I really aspire to spread the awareness, the culture that we talked about all over the society. Because, as I said, I consider it just a beginning. We need a lot of work as I said, further integration to facilitate the life to them, help them to overcome their difficulties, not only with sympathy, but with providing them with all they need. Really, I hope next year and to be there is a lot of integration, to see a lot of models in media, in education, in a lot of fields. Can also to pave the way to them to achieve themselves. I aspire also to anyone with disability to have their right to play their role in the society equally, because there is also some marginalization in some fields in jobs only for the disability. It's about the concept for the employers and the companies officials or are responsible for giving a job in either government or private sector don't distinguish the people with disabilities only because their disability, give them the opportunity, provide them with their tools, know what they need specifically.
Mr. Ahmed, before we wrap up today's episode with you, which was a very wonderful one, I just wanted to ask you a very important question. First of all, you were honored by President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi for editing the Braille magazine. How did you feel then when you were honored, of course, by the Egyptian president? And how did the Egyptian president witness you?
Was really my honor to be honored with by the president, Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. It highlights the role of people with disability in the community. Before, we can't see any attention to them. Now they sit in the front of every celebration or every conference. In Egypt now, Egypt is play a role in the region because it's the first country in the region to give this attention to people with disability. For me, especially, I tried to make something to make the difference in people with disabilities' lives, to provide them with culture. The Al-Akhbar Braille magazine was essentially about provide all people with disabilities, especially blind in the first stage, with the knowledge. Because one of the problems that faces people with disabilities is to get the culture properly.
But hopefully the efforts of the country, the efforts of President Assisi and your efforts, Mr. Ahmed Abu Humeila, would be growing in 2019. Thank you very much for being with us today on the Nile Cruise.
Thank you,
Mr. Ahmed Abu Humeila, the journalist and the member of the Youth Committee in the Culture Hire Committee. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for joining us.
We'll be having a quick break, so stay tuned.